to all you beautiful souls, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. For those of you here for the first time, my name's Terry. I'm an intuitive tarot reader, message bearer, and light worker. Today's tarot reading is a 2022 prediction. So what your year 2022 is going to hold, that's the questions we're going to ask of the spirit guides, angels, and ancestors, and we'll see what the cards come out. All right, so for reading selection, we have reading number one, reading number two, reading number three, reading number four, and reading number five. If you already have an intuitive selection method, you can go ahead and pause the video. Make sure you ask your spirit guides, angels, ancestors, which reading is for you. And jump ahead whenever you're ready. Now, for those of you who would like a little bit of assistance honing in with your intuition, I'll lead a short breathing exercise. Let's begin by closing our eyes. Take a slow, deep breath in. Hold for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, slowly release, letting your cares and worries float out of your body on your breath. Another slow, deep breath in. Hold for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Slowly release, asking which reading is for you. Another slow, deep breath in. Hold for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Slowly release. Now, one of the crystals or a number between 1 and 5 may just pop into your mind. If that happens, select that reading. If not, don't worry. One more slow, deep breath in. Hold for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Slowly release. Now, when you're ready, open your eyes and select the reading that calls out to you the most. Trust your first instincts. That's your intuition. All right, for reminders, we have reading number one, reading number two, reading number three, reading number four, and reading number five. Go ahead and use the timestamps in the comments and description to jump ahead to your reading, and I will see you there. Hello to all you beautiful souls who selected reading number one with the fluorite. All right, so your signifier card out of the Beyond Lumeria deck is healing. So 2022 is going to be a definite year of healing for you. Now, let's take a look at the transparent tarot and see any real significant things coming for 2022. So angels, spirit guides, ancestors, anything that you'd like to show them that's of significance for their 2022. All right, so you start with the Queen of Cups. Very nice. Ooh. You get strength. That's beautiful. And one more. All right, the Six of Cups. So there's going to be looking back and reminiscing, seeing how much you've grown in 2022. You've got strength coming out. That strength is beautiful. Look at the way that she's, you know, touching the animal. The strength is just, it's absolutely beautiful. Now, let's do one more transparent tarot. All right, you also get the Eight of Cups. So you are, you know, something is coming to a natural ending, but, you know, you're headed for the moon, you're headed for the stars, you know, you're headed for great things in 2022. Now, let's look at some of the specific things they'll encounter with the Tarot of Dreams. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors. For group number one, who's going to have a healing year full of hope and growth and emotional stability, may we please see what situations they're going to encounter in 2022. All right, so there's going to be challenges and tests. You know, that's what the King of Swords says. There's going to be challenges and tests, but you've got the strategy to overcome anything that you're going to step into. You also get the Four of Cups, so a little bit of looking at what you wish you had versus what you actually have, and possibly just a little bit of boredom in 2022. We're gonna get some oracle and see really what these are about. Now, what else? Ooh, the Ten of Cups. All right, that's a dream come true. Also, some of you will be moving homes in 2022 with this Ten of Cups coming out like this. This signifies a new home move for some of you, so congratulations on that. And then finally, you get the Page of Swords. So someone paying a little extra close attention. Now, let's see. So there's not any real specific timings on any of this, but there is this, you know, happy home, this wonderful, you know, dream home life that's in the Ten of Cups that's coming out for you. With you having all of these cups here, this is going to be an emotional year. You know, it's going to be an emotional year. You have the strength for everything that you're going to go through. It's going to be a year of healing for you. Now, for the King of Swords, that's your challenges and tests. Yeah, you're going to have, we all have challenges and tests. It's a whole year we're looking at. So I'm not surprised we've got some swords coming out. And then this Page of Swords can be somebody paying close attention to you, or you paying too close of attention to other people. But we'll also get some moonology for that. Now, before I dive into the moonology, I want to get you an angel card for 2022. So let's see what 2022 has from the angels for group number one. Ooh, Archangel Uriel, the Archangel of Wisdom. So you've got, you know, definite Archangel support. Call out to Archangel Uriel. He is there providing you the wisdom to step through your challenges and into your blessings. And these blessings look wonderful. Now, I want to get moonology for the swords. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors. This King of Swords talks about their challenges and tests and how they'll need their strategy. What can be added with moonology? All right, the end of a tough cycle approaches. So you guys already know, many of you, you already know, you're already in these challenges and tests, these struggles that you got going on. You know, you're going through them right now. This cycle is coming to an end. You're stepping out of those challenges and tests. See how it's just falling over? Okay, yeah, you're stepping out of those challenges and tests. So, you know, that is beautiful. Now, I would also like moonology for this Page of Swords. This Page of Swords was either you paying too close of attention or someone paying too close of attention to you. Work through your fears. All right. So don't judge yourself. For some of you, this is a social media thing. And it's not like you're creeping on somebody's social media. You're judging yourself by others' social media. Work through your fears. You are perfect just the way you are. So just, you know, I know that's a really specific message. Just take it as it resonates. But you are perfect just the way you are. Don't judge yourself by what you see on social media. You do not need to change you. All right. Now, let's get back to the cups. Okay, so I want to get Queen of the moon for the Four of Cups and the Ten of Cups. So for this boredom that you may be facing in the Four of Cups, discernment. Okay. So you're told discernment. Now, sometimes the Four of Cups is also about looking at what you wish you had versus what you actually had. You see how he's looking at the cup up here that is all full and wonderful and doesn't even pay attention to the cups at his feet? This is saying follow your gut, okay? Don't daydream about what you wish you had. Follow your gut and actually manifest what you want. Bring to you what you want and, you know, really use your gut to get there. Now, for the Ten of Cups, darkness. All right, so some of you are like, how is this going to happen for me? How is this, you know, wonderful home move? How is it going to happen for me? Because it's coming to you out of the darkness. So just know it may not be there on January 1st, 2022, okay? It may be there in December of 2022, because this is a whole year we're looking at. But it's going to come to you, this beautiful, happy home. Not everybody's moving. This is a general reading. But some of you are definitely moving, so congratulations on that. But this is a happy home that's going to come out of the darkness for you. Now, I would like to see what the Spellcasting Oracle has to add for the Transparent Tarot. So, for this lovely strength and growth, oh, you get forgiveness. Okay, so those of you that are not forgiving yourselves for something, it's time. 2022 is your year. It's time to forgive. For those of you that need to forgive someone else, please let it be a year of forgiveness. You know, reach into your heart, reach into your soul. Forgiveness is actually not for them. It's for you. It's to free you. So, you know, forgiveness across the board, wherever it's needed. Now, let's see what the Tiny Starseed Oracle has to add for your 2022. So, out of the Tiny Starseed Oracle, all right, we'll cut to them. You start with guidance. You are not alone. You are guided by masters and teachers of the highest realms. All right, so you are not alone. You are being guided. You're being brought out of these challenges and tests into a wonderful new cycle. You also get creation. Being creative is a wonderful way to witness the unfolding of your limitless creative soul. So be creative, work through your fears, don't judge yourself by what you think others think of you. Don't worry about what anyone thinks of you, just be you. Finally, you get dreams. The universe speaks to you through your dreams, so pay attention to those dreams. Now, I want to give the Tiny Tarot a chance for any additional messages for anyone in reading number one. So, out of the Tiny Tarot, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, any additional messages for anyone in reading number one? All right. Let's see what those three are. All right, you got the Five of Pentacles, the Seven of Pentacles, and the Lovers. So the Five of Pentacles talks about fear around money, fear around loneliness, and the Seven of Pentacles talks about waiting, that you're going to get there. So for those of you that are worried about money, this is a very clear, hey, stop worrying about money. It's going to be there. You're going to have what you need. You just have to wait while it ripens. And then finally, you got the Lovers. So some of you are going to be meeting somebody in 2022. You know, the Lovers comes out, it talks about a soulmate connection, it talks about meeting somebody, it talks about committing to somebody. So for some of you, that's part of your 2022 as well. All right, that is all I have for reading number one today. Thank you so much for choosing me as your tarot reader. Thank you for clicking the like and subscribe button. I really appreciate it. Until next time, love, light, courage, and strength to each and every one of you. Bye-bye. Hello to all you beautiful souls who selected reading number 2 with the black tourmaline. All right, your signifier for the reading is Internal Explorer. So 2022 is going to be a year of internal exploration for you. Now, let's take a look at the Transparent Tarot for any major events that are coming, any wonderful blessings, anything like that, that they can expect for 2022. So angels, spirit guides, ancestors, please show us any wonderful blessings, any events that they can expect. All right, so you start with the Five of Cups. Then the Nine of Pentacles. Judgment. Okay, and let's get one more. Okay, that looks beautiful. All right, so yeah, you have the Five of Cups, which talks about looking at what you've lost versus looking at what you still have. You've got this, like it basically drew you a picture. This is the wonderful meadow that you've got going on here is your Empress. So this can connote motherhood. So some of you will step into motherhood in 2022. Now, notice how the scales are filled with this nine of pentacles, which is essentially the Nine of Coins. It talks about rewarding yourself with luxuries. So you need to reward yourself with luxuries, but you also need to balance it with good, strong, you know, sound judgments and whatnot. So just take what resonates, but you will be rewarding yourself with luxuries in 2022. Now, let's take a look at what the Tarot of Dreams has to add. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, please use the Tarot of Dreams and show us some of the situations they'll encounter in 2022. All right, so Ace of Swords, you've got a new beginning coming out. Palace of Swords, so you're going to be taking action in 2022. Five of Coins. All right, so you guys are feeling some fear. We'll get some Moonology and see how you step out of that Five of Coins. And then Queen of Cups. So you are absolutely strong enough for any and everything that gets thrown your way in 2022. You've got a new beginning where you're going to need to be taking some action. And then the Palace of Swords even coming out saying you need to meditate a little bit and figure out what action you need to be taking. The Five of Coins talks about some fear around poverty, loss, loneliness. You know, it's the fear of it. But we'll get Moonology and see how you step out of that. And then your Queen of Cups talks about your emotional strength and you being strong enough for whatever happens for you in 2022. It looks very beautiful. It looks like the scales are tipped towards you being able to reward yourself financially so you don't need to have this fear. Now, before we jump into Moonology with the coins, let's take a look and see what angel card comes out for you for 2022. Happiness. Oh, that's beautiful. I'm so glad you get happiness. Happiness is going to shine on you in 2022. It's going to be wonderful. Now, I want to get right into Moonology and see how you step out of this Five of Coins. This Five of Coins is the fear of loss. It's the fear of lack. How do they step out of it, spirit guides? You need to have faith in your dreams. Okay. Have faith in your dreams. Do not believe that this is going to go badly for you. Excuse me, I'm still recovering. But yeah, don't worry, don't fret, don't worry that things are not going to work out. Have faith that your dreams are going to bring things to fruition. You know what? I would also like Moonology for this Palace of Swords. The Palace of Swords says you need to take some time and figure out what action you need to take. It's time to release negativity. All right, you heard it there. It's time for the negativity to go. So just, you know, figure out what action you need to take to release that negativity as you step into 2022. Now, for the Ace of Swords, I would like to get the Queen of the Moon. So, out of Queen of the Moon for the Ace of Swords. Acceptance. All right. So, you are going to need to accept this wonderful new beginning where you're taking some form of action for the beginning to start. So, this is you taking action somewhere and you accepting the action you need to take. Definitely negativity has got to be released. Now, let's also do Queen of the Moon for the Queen of Cups. So, for the Queen of Cups, ooh, power. All right, you are a powerful being in 2022. Most definitely. You are emotionally strong enough to deal with anything that gets thrown your way. And you have got all of this power coming to the table. Now, you've got this beautiful motherhood for some of you. It's got balance. It's got, you know, it's the Justice card is here. There is the beautiful, you know, rewarding yourself with luxuries and the Nine of Coins or the Nine of Pentacles. And then you have that Five of Cups, which talks about still looking at what you've lost, looking at what you've, you know, what you're afraid you're going to lose. So have faith in those dreams and know that this is going to be a great year for you. You're going to start something brand new. You're going to release the negativity. You're going to accept this new start, and it's going to be fantastic. Now, I'd like to get the Spellcasting Oracle for the Transparent Tarot just to see what there is to add to that. So, out of the Transparent Tarot, compassion. Okay, show yourself a little bit of compassion, all right? Really be kind to yourself as you step into 2022. Treat yourself the way you would like to treat your best friend. That is how you should treat yourself. Now, let's see what the little starseed deck has to add for group number two. So, out of the starseed deck. All right, we'll cut to them. You get strength. You are being guided by the cosmos. Stay strong. A positive outcome is assured. Yeah, you are strong. This is a wonderful thing that you're stepping into. Vision. Trust your ability to create the vision in your soul. You are powerful. See the world, see your world the way you want it to be. And step into that new beginning. Finally, you get choice. By staying conscious in your thoughts, you guide your journey in the direction of choice. So show yourself some compassion. Keep your thoughts positive. Keep them on the path that you want to be on, and it will take you directly there. Now, I have the Tiny Tarot deck for any additional messages for reading number two. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, any additional messages for reading number two, please? Okay, that's enough. So, some of you are getting married with this Four of Wands that flew off the desk. Ooh, the Wheel of Fortune. Things look good for you guys. You also have the Page of Pentacles, the Four of Cups, and the Seven of Cups. So you guys have opportunities coming in. You're being gifted something. Wait for the right opportunity for you. So wait until your gut says, this one's for you. That's the message there. But you've got those opportunities coming in. For those of you that are getting married, congratulations. It looks beautiful. You've got the Wheel of Fortune coming out, so luck and fate are on your side. It looks like a beautiful, happy union, so just relax. Everything looks great. All right, that is all I have for reading number two today. Thank you so much for choosing me as your tarot reader. Thank you for clicking the like and subscribe button. I really appreciate it. Until next time, love, light, courage, and strength to each and every one of you. Bye-bye. Hello to all you beautiful souls who selected reading number 3 with the clear quartz. All right, your signifier for the reading is full spectrum. So for 2022, you're going to be really getting in touch with your spiritual side and, you know, aligning these chakras and whatnot. You're stepping into the full spectrum. Now, let's take a look at any significant things that are going to happen with the transparent tarot. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, anything significant for group number 3 in 2022, please show us using the transparent tarot. All right, so you start with the 4 of wands. So, some of you are getting married. Ooh, the Knight of Wands, a passionate proposal. So some of you have not even had the proposal yet, and you're going to be getting married. Now, we have the Hanging Man. So it may be not quite 2022 when you get married, or it may be towards the end of 2022, because that kind of signifies a little bit of a delay. Now, let's do one more. Ooh, the 3 of wands. There's celebrations. Like, look at the picture that this is building. This is an absolute celebration of passion. Many of you are getting married or stepping into wonderfully passionate relationships in 2022. That looks beautiful. That's like a really significant thing. And it's going to be transformative for you, because see how this hanging man is represented by the chrysalis? You know, and this being from the 3 of wands is wearing the chrysalis around his neck now. You know, this is you being the part of this transformative relationship, whether it is a, you know, love relationship, a love match, a friendship. It could be a really productive business relationship even. But this Knight of Wands is, you know, there's definitely a proposal for you that you're going to be passionate about. So congratulations. Now, let's see what situations you'll be dealing with in 2022. So out of the Tarot of Dreams, please, whatever situations you'd like to talk to them about 2022, angels, spirit guides, ancestors. Ooh, all right. You start with the King of Coins. Very nice. All right, so the 8 of Swords. So there's some stuck energy too. Your King of Coins is a really loving, generous energy. It's a beautiful energy to be interacting with, whether it represents you or someone else. Now you got your Queen of Wands. That's you stepping into your more authentic self in 2022. And then strength. You've got the strength coming out because you're absolutely strong enough for whatever you face. So really, the only issue you have is the swords. You've got the 8 of swords saying there's some stuck energy going on in 2022. But we will get some moonology and see how you step out of this stuck energy. Before I do that, I want to see what angel message you get to govern your 2022. Then. So angels for group number 3 for 2022. Gratitude. All right, you heard it there. So just remember, be grateful for the wonderful things that are coming in for you, because there are wonderful things. This looks beautiful, whatever this is. You know, this is all kinds of passion and celebration and good times. So it's, you know, and it's definitely you being, you know, something is being offered to you here. Now, I would like to see what Moonology has to say for that 8 of Swords. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, for the 8 of Swords, how do they step out of this stuck energy in the 8 of Swords? Balance spirituality and practicality. All right. So, wherever you're stuck, you know, you've got to let go of that energy, but you've got to also do the practical side of things. You've got to step out of the stuck energy and start moving forward. You know, as difficult as that is. So wherever you encounter this stuck energy, balance your spirituality and your practicality, and take the steps that you need to move out of that energy, to kind of break the energy up. Now, I would like to see what Queen of the Moon has to say for this Queen of Wands. Because the Queen of Wands is you stepping into your more authentic self. You being truly, authentically you. And you get trust. All right, you need to trust that your true, authentic self is what the world needs from you. It absolutely is. You being you is exactly what the universe needs. Now, also, let's do Queen of the Moon for the King of Coins. You get focus. All right, so this is also kind of an intuitive focus. You can step into this King of Coins energy where you want for nothing and you have plenty to share and you do share it. So really focus, you can bring your focus in and step into this energy in 2022. So, you know, just take it as it resonates, but, you know, use those manifestations, really use those, use that third eye, use those manifestations, use that vision and create that abundance that you're looking for. Now, I would like to see what the spellcasting oracle says for strength. Because strength just means exactly that. It means you're plenty strong enough for everything you're going to encounter in 2022. Ooh, fertility. You're also plenty strong enough for motherhood for some of you. And just take it as it resonates. Like when we see the fertility card come out, some of you, it's like you just found out and you know you're going to be a mother in 2022, so congratulations. Some of you already know you're going to be mothers in 2022. But either way, the fertility card is coming out saying you're plenty strong enough for whatever you're faced with. Now, I would also like one of these spellcasting oracles for the Transparent Tarot. That is just, it's a beautiful proposal. It's a beautiful whirlwind romance. It is a transformative thing for you. And I would like to see healing. Oh, it's a beautiful healing. All right, that's fantastic. So just, you know, take your healing and really let it heal your soul. You know, let your soul heal with these relationships, with these, you know, opportunities that come to you. They're going to be transformative for you in 2022. Now, let's see what the Starseed Oracle has to add. So, for group number 3. All right, we'll cut to them. You get Inner Alchemy. Inner Alchemy is achieved when you react to fear with love. So do not be afraid about this abundance that you're talking about bringing in. For those of you that really want this abundance, you know, it's okay. You can manifest this. Replace the fear that you feel about the situation with absolute love and call it to you. Now, you also get Starseed. Raise the vibration of the planet through your radiant, loving light. So for some of you, that's just confirmation that you're a starseed. And then advancement. A strong energy is propelling you forward. Follow the stirrings of your heart. So for those of you that are afraid of this passionate relationship, that's where your stuck energy is, don't be afraid. This is a healing relationship for you. Follow your heart, where your heart leads you. It's not going to lead you wrong. All right, now I have the Tiny Tarot deck for any additional messages for group number 3. So angels, spirit guides, ancestors. Nope, that's too many. We'll take these two and then we'll see if we need some more. All right, so you got the Queen of Swords and the Queen of Cups. Okay, so the Queen of Swords is the mama bear. She's the tiger. She, you know, has the sharp tongue and defends her young and whatnot. And the Queen of Cups, she is your more emotionally sure, you know, she's more mature emotionally. So, you know, this, I think, represents different aspects of some of your lives. Now, let's see what there is to add to these queens. So you've got the queens coming out. What is there to add to the queens? All right, so we've got the devil and the hierophant. Okay, so you do not have to get married if you don't want to get married, okay? There is romantic proposals. There is a wedding here for many of you, so just take it as it resonates. But you've got the devil coming out with the hierophant, and you've got the queens. So for those of you that don't want this, don't do it. You know, you don't have to step into this devil energy. The devil is there because you feel trapped. The hierophant is there symbolizing marriage, like the you know, actual institution of marriage. So just take it as it resonates. If you were excited about hearing that you've got a proposal coming, then fantastic. If marriage feels like the devil to you, then don't worry about it. You don't have to step into it, okay? All right, that is all I have for reading number 3. Thank you so much for choosing me as your tarot reader today. Thank you for clicking the like and subscribe button. I really appreciate it. Until next time, love, light, courage, and strength to each and every one of you. Bye-bye. Hello to all you beautiful souls who selected reading number 4 with the sodalite. All right, your signifier for the reading is sacral chakra, core of creation. So 2022 is going to be a very creative month for many of you. Or month, year, I mean. It's going to be a very creative year for many of you. Now, let's take a look at what specific significant situations are going to happen for group number 4 in 2022. So angels, spirit guides, ancestors, please show us any significant situations coming in 2022 for group number 4, please. All right, so the 7 of Wands. All right, so death, so the end of something for the start of something new. You got your 10 of Pentacles, so that is beautiful. And let's pull one more. All right, so some rest. I feel like just one more. All right, the 3 of Cups. Okay. So you have got celebrations and rest. There is fighting for what you want still, but stepping into abundance, and something is ending in your 2022. So that's what the Transparent Tarot is saying. You're going to get some rest. The 4 of Swords talks about you getting rest, you being protected. This death card coming out, that doesn't mean death. It means the end of something for the rebirth of something. So something new is coming. It's definitely going to take you to a place of wonderful abundance because you got the 10 of Pentacles coming out. And see how the 10 of Pentacles kind of starts the sheath and the way the picture gets drawn out. And then this 3 of Cups, that's celebrations. So the fighting is in the background. Like the fighting, there is a fighting in the 7 of Swords, a putting your energy in but winning. And here's you celebrating your win. So everything looks beautiful for 2022. Now, let's see what the Tarot of Dreams has to add for specific situations that they're going to encounter in 2022. So angels, spirit guides, ancestors, the specific situations they're going to encounter in 2022, please. Fighting. All right. See, you get the fighting again. So there's going to be some fighting in 2022. King of Swords, there's some challenges and tests. All right. We'll see what the Moonology says about those Ooh, there's some travel for some of you with the Three of Wands coming out. There's definite good news coming in 2022. And then you get the King of Coins. So there is definitely abundance. That's your second time seeing abundance in this reading. So it definitely looks like there's abundance headed your way. Now, before we jump into the oracle for the tarot, let's see what the angels have to add for your reading. So, angels for 2022 for group four. Harmony, I love it. All right, so there's going to be living in harmony. And, well, so you got harmony. So the goal is going to be moving into living in harmony, okay? You're going to come out of this fighting. You're going to have to fight for what you want, but you're going to win. This fighting is going to be over and you're going to live in harmony. So just know it's kind of, you're going to get there. It's a path. Now let's take a look and see how you step out of the Five of Wands. So angels, spirit guides, ancestors, how do they step out of this fighting in the Five of Wands? All right, nothing will come of the situation. So the fighting is all for naught, so don't even bother with it, really. You know, that's the thing. Nothing's going to come of the fight. So where you have to put your energy in here, where you are, you know, really following your creative endeavors and you're going to win over here, this is not fighting. This is just fighting to fight. And nothing's going to come of this fighting over here. Now, let's see what... I would also like Moonology for the King of Swords, please. Show the world the real you. All right, so the King of Swords talks about challenges and tests and you having the strategy in you to get through them. Show the world the real you is exactly the strategy you need to use to get through the challenges and tests that 2022 is going to hold for you. You need to show the world who you really are and just be truly, authentically yourself. Now, let's see what Queen of the Moon has to add for this King of Coins over here. Ooh, beauty. All right, so the abundance that you're going to step into in 2022 is beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. You know what? We'll do Queen of the Moon for the Three of Wands as well. Ooh, purity. All right, so the good news that comes in is of a pure nature. It's a very pure version. And you've got purity. So this represents travel and good news coming in. There's definite, you know, pure joy in some of this. This is a very joyous setup here. Now, let's see what the Spellcasting Oracle has to say for the Transparent Tarot. All right, so what is there to add? Ooh, career. All right, so some of you are making lots of headway in your career. Something is ending for you to make good movements forward in your career field. So it looks good. Like, your career looks really good for 2022. Now, let's see what the little starseed deck has to add. Ooh. You start with love. Live your truth and share the love that's in your soul. All right, so instead of fighting, share the love in your soul. Okay. Creation. Being creative is a wonderful way of witnessing the unfolding of your limitless creative soul. All right, so be creative. Really, you know, step outside the box. Now, one more. All right, we'll cut to it. You get celebration. Celebrate your achievements. You are truly a gift to the universe. Yes, you guys deserve this promotion. You deserve this step up the career ladder. So just, and take it as it resonates. This is a general reading. So there's lots of stuff here. There's some stuff for everybody that's here. But just celebrate yourself. You are worthy of this step in the right direction career-wise. Now, I have the Tiny Tarot deck for any additional messages for group number four. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, any additional messages for group number four, please? All right, so you guys got the Nine of Pentacles and the Three of Cups. Well, that's your second time with the Three of Cups. There's lots of celebration, and you need to reward yourself with luxuries. When you see the Nine of Pentacles, that's saying, hey, spend a little bit of money on yourself. Do something beautiful for yourself, okay? So just take it as it resonates. You're being told by your spirit guides that you need to celebrate a little bit and do something nice for yourself. So, all right, that is all I have for reading number four today. Thank you so much for choosing me as your tarot reader. Thank you for clicking the like and subscribe button. I really appreciate it. Until next time, love, light, courage, and strength to each and every one of you. Bye-bye. Hello to all you beautiful souls who selected reading number five with the obsidian. All right, let's take a look at your signifier. You get trust your innocence. All right, so trust yourself in 2022. That's good advice always, but trust your innocence. Now, let's take a look at the transparent tarot and see any real significant things that are coming in 2022. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, anything really significant coming in 2022 for group number five, please. All right, you got the Star. That's beautiful. All right, the Ten of Swords. So something is ending. The Five of Wands. All right, what else? The Knight of Wands. And you know what? One more. The Fool. All right, so you guys are on a brand new journey that's going to bring you healing. Something is going to come to a complete end, okay? Something is going to come to a definitive end, and that's why that Ten of Swords is there. But there is some there. I mean, there is a little bit of struggle with the Five of Wands here. But you've got a wonderful whirlwind romance with something, and the Fool's journey. So something new, something that you're beginning that's absolutely wonderfully new, that's going to help you transform into a more authentic you. Now, let's take a look at Tarot of Dreams and see what some of the situations you're going to encounter in 2022 are. So, angels, spirit guides, ancestors, please show us the situations they're going to encounter in 2022. All right. All right, so you got the Five of Cups. So there's some looking at what you've lost over what you still have. We'll see how you step out of that. All right, there's some worry. We all deal with worry. We'll also see it. There's your strength coming out. All right, good deal. So you're strong enough for any and everything that you encounter in 2022. And then the Three of Wands. You have also got travel in your 2022. You've got good news coming in and travel for many of you. Now, the Five of Cups talks about looking at what you've lost over looking at what you still have. The Five of Swords talks about worry around work or home life. Then you have strength coming out, showing your strength, and the Three of Wands with good news coming in. So let's pull an angel card that'll kind of govern your whole 2022, and then we'll look at some moonology for those fives. Now, let's see, from the angels for reading number five, you're told to be free. Absolutely. This is the year for you to be free, to soar. That's why you have the Fool in your transparent tarot. It's saying you are at the beginning of a journey and you can just, you can fly free and soar. Now, I want to see what Moonology has to say about the fives. So how do they step out of this Five of Cups energy? All right, a win-win outcome is forecast. So when you find yourself looking at what you've lost versus what you still have, looking at it and going, oh my goodness, we've lost this, we've lost that. First off, start counting your blessings. And secondly, remember that this is a win-win outcome is forecast. So whatever it is you feel like you've lost, it's really not lost to you. It's just transitioning. Now, for the Five of Swords, what is there to step out of the Five of Swords? All right, you're told to be bold and make the first move. The Five of Swords is worry. So decide you're not going to have a year where you worry. You know, really decide you're going to put worry behind you and make that first move to let go of the constant worrying. You have the strength inside you, and this looks like a fantastic year. So there's not anything to worry about. Now, let's see what is going to come out of the Queen of the Moon for the Strength card. Abundance. Yep, you are stepping into a wonderful abundance. You know what? For the Three of Wands as well. Faith. You need to have faith that good news is headed your way. That, you know, you've got travel in this next year coming for you. You've got wonderful things coming. So be excited about it. Now, let's see what the Spellcasting Oracle has to add for the Transparent Tarot. Empowerment. Yes, no, this is empowerment for you. You are going to find yourself empowered to step into your fool's journey, to really take what's being offered to you by the universe here, because it is healing and wonderful. And yes, there's an ending, but it's a brand new, wonderful beginning. Now, let's see what the star seeds have to add to your reading. So we'll take that one, and that one, and that one. All right, so you started with patience. Be patient and allow destiny to unfold at its own pace. So know that you are gonna win, but things move at the speed of the universe, okay? So just know that this wonderful new beginning is headed your way, this new fool's journey, but you have to be patient and allow it to come to you. Next, you get advancement. A strong energy is propelling you forward. Follow the stirrings of your heart. All right, that's beautiful. And finally, you get choice. By staying conscious in your thoughts, you guide your journey in the direction of choice. All right. There you go. Really guide your journey the direction you want it to go. Step out of this worry. Don't let yourself go. Take your worry into 2022. Leave it in 2021. It doesn't need to go with you. You've got wonderful new things coming in. You need to have faith and you need to guide your path in the direction of choice. Now, let's take a look at the Tiny Tarot for any additional messages for reading number 5. So, any additional messages for reading number 5. That's too many. All right, so you got fast-moving spirit guide messages, fast-moving situations. So, you guys are going to be dealing with things coming at you quickly, moving quickly. See, they keep just trying to, that's too many. We need just a couple. Okay. All right. So you got the Five of Cups again. So fast moving situation. So the Five of Cups is not going to last long. For those of you that are worried about this Five of Cups and you looking at what you lost, it's not going to last long. It's going to move quickly. This Eight of Wands is saying, hey, that Five of Cups is going to be over quickly. So don't worry about that. I want that to be really clear. This is not going to be a long-lasting energy that sticks with you through 2022. You're going to step right out of it into a wonderful win-win, and it's going to move quickly. All right, that is all I have for reading number 5 today. Thank you so much for choosing me as your tarot reader. Thank you for clicking the like and subscribe button. I really appreciate it. Until next time, love, light, courage, and strength to each and every one of you. Bye-bye.